Hello, did you know that the genome of our cell is around, say, 6 billion base pairs? And if we take the diploid cell of our genome from one cell and put all the chromosomes one after one like this, attach them end to end, it would be about 2 meters. That is, it is longer than many of us. But then this whole DNA is put into a tiny nucleus around, say, 10 micrometers. How is this compaction possible? That is because of supercoiling, and that is because of topological changes that are induced by several enzymes. I am BCMR, Assistant Professor at Shastra. Today we'll discuss about topology and supercoiling and their physiological or biological relevance and significance. First thing, topology is the study of geometric properties in mathematics and spatial relations. And you can also simplistically think of the way in which constituent parts are interrelated or arranged. Say, for example, I have this strap of crumpled aluminium foil. And this is, say, we call it state 1, which I'm putting it as something linear like this. And I'm putting the same one in a different, some other shape. It's just crumbled over. Now, if you look at this, is there any change in the number of molecules? Is there any change in the any amount of volume it has occupied? Actually not. But then these are in two different forms, and that is what comes under topology. How one part of itself is arranged to another part of it. That is, you can call them all as different topological forms or topoisomers, probably. So the topoisomers, especially in cases of DNA, DNA is a very long molecule because it's a polymer of nucleotides, and it can change or have different shapes. And this, the topology of DNA is highly regulated within the cells for several reasons. First of all, is to, in our cells, it has to be compacted and made into a small, or fit into a small nucleus, and at the same time be able to express the genes as well. So DNA can, the same DNA when present in different forms, we call them, or we refer to them as topoisomers. So we'll have to understand a few concepts in topology, and we will try to do it in most simplest forms as usual. What we know, we can recall that when we studied about DNA structure, we know that one coil or one turn is about, say, 10.5 base pairs in B form. So we know that there is one strand crossing over the other strand, and that makes it one turn, and that is called twist. Twist is, in simplistically put, if you assume these are two DNA strands, and one is crossing over the other like this, that is one twist. They could have been just simply in straight like this, but that's not how the structure of DNA molecule is. One turn, one crosses over the other, that is one twist. When it comes back and goes again, that is the second twist. We have two turns right now, here and here. When this goes again and crosses on it again, that is twist number 3. And it would keep on going, twist number 4. If we recollect the number of how many twists would have normally occurred in general, then it would be very easy to answer as well. Say, for example, if I had a 100 base pair DNA, then we could expect approximately, say, 10 turns. And in these 10 turns, in each turn, we have one twist. So we could expect about twist is equal to 10. That is the very normal or stable form of the supercoiling that is present. If a 100 base pair DNA has more number of turns, like this, say for example, if we are taking it and try to put in, induce more twists within the same amount of DNA, say 100 base pairs, then it has more number of twists compared to what it should be having. And then we would call it as positive supercoiling, which we will again discuss in a while. If the same 100 base pairs DNA has less than 10 twists, then we can call it as negative supercoiling. Then we will also, I have a piece of wire that I have interwoven to represent the two strands of DNA, and in its state as it sits, we can call it as when it has relaxed. So write this something, let's try to unwind it. So I have tied the knot actually, and I'm trying to unwind. You can take maybe a simpler one. I had another piece of wire here to demonstrate what exactly right is. We'll go into the positive supercoiling, negative supercoiling in a while. I have a wire, a cord from the earphones, and then I'm twisting it further. I'm just inducing one side, I have put it stable, and the other side, I'm increasing the twist. I hope you can see that there is a change in there. And you see that some structures are forming. And that formation of those structures is writhe. Writhe can be two different forms, but we will just simply say, this is what is happening. This is writhe. A molecule folding upon itself. So I hope you understood the difference between twist. Twist is the number of times it is crossing, one strand crossing over another. And writhe is about one part of the molecule folding upon the other in to demonstrate something like this. This is, you increase one fold, that is twist. If this goes something like this, that is writhe. So writhe is kind of compensation for the stress that the DNA strands or the phosphate backbones are experiencing because of increased or decreased number of twists. So we will also have a small discussion on the writhe, the demonstration for it. I hope you can see this, and I'm now unwinding it. And if you keep on unwinding, you will see that the strands are becoming more and more. It's actually very tough to do this. It depends on the material you have chosen to demonstrate. And you can see that, say, if this was the DNA strands, you will see that the hydrogen bonds are breaking, or the two strands are separating actually. And I'm not doing anything, but I'm bringing it closer, and it is forming a structure, that is, it is forming a writhe, that is writhe. Writhe is kind of compensating for the stress that has been induced. Say for example, I release this end and I will try to undo whatever I have done, and this is the same one. And now I'm trying to bring it close and it is not doing anything. You can't see any writhe formation. Right, previously, what I did was I induced negative supercoiling means I was breaking or I was reducing the number of twists that this particular strand has. And you can redo it again. I'm just bringing it and it is forming structures by itself like this. And I'm trying to pull and there is resistance as well. That is right. You can also induce positive supercoiling, that is increase the more more number of twists than it would normally have. And I'm trying to do that and it's a little tougher, and you can already see that it is forming structures, and you can see that is how it is, the mechanical or the stress is being compensated by the formation of these. I can leave it like that and it will hold the structure as such. So if I undo whatever twists I have induced and I leave it, it doesn't form any structure. We do experience these things often. We, as a child, we might have been playing, and these are exactly the ways even DNA behaves. And there are several important things that we need to remember. I hope you understood what is twist and what is writhe. Linking number is equal to twist plus writhe. So twist can be positive or negative. So can writhe. So we don't need to go into further details, but I hope you understood twist and writhe and how they are directly implicated in or involved or are useful for the understanding of DNA, the structural changes that it can have. So we did discuss positive and positive and negative supercoiling. Majority of the DNA in all our cells is negatively supercoiled. I mean, there are many ways of how, why they are positively supercoiled. Say for example, if I try to perform transcription or translation, and if the enzyme RNA polymerase is in here and it is trying to go towards the other end, and imagine if this other end is fixed, and if we keep on going, you can see that the positive supercoiling is increasing. So there should be a way of reducing this tension somehow. If it were negatively supercoiled, then we could, the enzyme can travel much farther. So negative supercoiling is beneficial or preferred in majority of the cellular systems. Positive supercoiling is also useful, especially in the cases of thermophiles. Positive supercoiling is, or thermophiles live in ecosystems that are in hot water, hot springs, which may reach above the boiling point or nearby boiling point, about 100 degrees centigrade. And we, as we studied about the stability of the DNA, we know that DNA, when heated, will denature. And that is not good for the DNA, I mean, to function as a genome. So there should be some mechanisms to ensure that this DNA do not denature and remains as double-stranded DNA. One way, of course, is to increase the amount of GC content that is visible. But it is also, it is insufficient, especially in temperatures that are ranging about 100 degrees centigrade. In those cases, positive supercoiling is very useful to keep the genome in double-stranded state. And this is what has been the reason why thermophiles have high GC content and also the positive supercoiling of the genome. But otherwise, majority of the other genomes, we would find it is negative supercoiled or relaxed state. See, we discussed 100 base pairs, the linking number or just twist should have been about 10. And if it is 10, then 100 base pair DNA has twist of 10. We can call it as relaxed. If 100 base pairs had twist about, say, 7, then it is negatively supercoiled. If a similar DNA has about 12, then it is positively supercoiled. So that is how we denote this. The importance of it comes when we talk about DNA in terms of electrophoresis. Say for example, if we were performing electrophoresis of the DNA and say topoisomers, in which case one of it is just relaxed, another one is very supercoiled. And if we allowed these to undergo electrophoresis, we would have put the negative electrode here and the positive electrode here. Negative electrode because DNA is negatively charged because of the phosphate backbone, and when the electricity is applied, it will travel in this direction. So the molecular weight of these two topoisomers, one is linear and one is relaxed and one is supercoiled, is same. Molecular weight is same, but the topology is different. And if electrophoresis is conducted, then we would notice that the relaxed one travels little slower compared to that of the supercoiled one. The supercoiled one is much more compact because of this riots, and therefore it will pass through the pores in the agarose very easily compared to that of the linear DNA. Therefore, there too we will find that the supercoiling of the DNA is important. I hope you got an understanding of the supercoiling or linking number twist, right? A linking number, a negative supercoiling and positive supercoiling. Thank you very much. We'll see you again in the next video.